two stories for the Canucks tonight. Let's start off with the more negative story. Canucks lost to the Red Wings. It was a 3-2 game, and unfortunately, if it weren't for, like, the last minute and a half, the game would have been tied. But that is no excuse for this loss, because the Canucks, well, their bounces didn't really go their way. A lot of chances that the Canucks have, they didn't really bury it, and overall, up until, like, the mid-third period, it was a pretty bad game, to be honest. The only Canuck that was actually playing all right, I guess, it was Markstrom, and I'm gonna say Pouliot as well, but for the most part, the Canucks' execution just wasn't there for the first two periods. There were good opportunities, there were good chances, like some shots on the rush, and Henrik Sedin on his low-key breakaway, but overall, the finishing and the execution was not there in the first little bit of this game, and it continued up until the point where it was like, okay, well, Detroit, they have two, and it's the start of the third period, so up until, like, the midway mark of the third period, the Canucks were kind of trash. So 7 minutes into the third period, Daniel Sedin is able to get one, so that's pretty good. This big scramble in front of the net, Daniel does his little thing where he tucks the puck in, that's good. And after the Delzotto goal in the mid-third period, that was really when the Canucks turned it on, because the Canucks tied this game 9:30 into the third, and it was a good break-in. I really thought the break-in was good. Horvat comes in, he's got speed, he reverses, flips himself around, he chucks it back over to the point, Delzotto comes rushing in, as John Garrett said, right down Main Street, dekes his way past one guy, he's in the clear, snipes it top corner, Delzotto's got his first as a Canuck. And it was at that point that the Canucks were really starting to play motivated, and it was a good game from that point on, up until the last little bit. But I want to talk about this game a little bit, because shots on goal were 29-28, so Markstrom, he didn't play a bad game, let's be honest. There were a few goals early on that Markstrom probably, maybe, should not have let in, however, it happened, and he still played well for the rest of the game, so it's fine. But Thomas Tatar's goal at the end, the game winner, was unlucky. It was really unlucky for Markstrom. In my opinion, I thought it was going wide, but then it gets hit on the inside of Markstrom's arm and it goes right in, so that's the game. Overall, I'm disappointed, because even though we did score two goals and we were pretty fire for the last little bit of the third, I don't believe the Canucks had a good game. This game was kind of trash. It was bad, and a lot of the execution power was not there. And if anything, this game proves as a lesson that the Canucks really need to work on their finishing more. Maybe it's just the ice in Rogers Arena or not, but the bounces in this game were not lucky, and the Canucks were having a hard time really controlling the play in some areas. Their breakout was iffy at times, and it wasn't really until the third that I felt confident that this team would have been able to come in and score goals. And I had issues with the closing segment of the game. So Canucks, it's like less than 5 seconds left, and they're trying to replicate the LA to Foley shot and goal with like 0.9 seconds left. Canucks are trying to replicate that, and they got guys, you know, Henrik's out there, Horvat's there, Berchi, Besser, Delzotto, and I had a problem with how they didn't give it to Besser. I don't want to be seen as like a fanboy here, fanboying out, but Delzotto was at the point. He had so much room on both his left and his right side. There was like a second left. And instead of passing it over to Besser, who's got that deadly one-timer, he decides to shoot it. He decides to shoot it like twice in two separate plays. And that really was a kill for me, because in my opinion, I was like, yo, Besser just did a few good one-timers. He's look at his hustle. Besser's hustle out there in the last, like, 10 seconds of the game was really strong. And it's a shame that Horvat wasn't able to put in that rebound, but hockey is hockey, and hockey happens. But a lot of the players, Delzotto especially, I didn't feel gave themselves the best opportunity to win. Because when you're at the point with a second left, you've got an opportunity there, Delzotto. You can shoot it like you did earlier. You can try to replicate that snipe you did even earlier in the game, or you can pass it off to Besser, who has a significantly higher chance of scoring. But, you know, it's hockey, and who knows, if Besser shot it, maybe they would have saved it, maybe it would have gone in, who knows, but the fact is, the Canucks didn't really utilize their last second of the game correctly, in my opinion. They didn't utilize it to the best of their ability, and it really came to bite them because you see this a lot with the Canucks, where they don't really play well in the beginning, and then they usually put their pants on at the very end of the game when it's far too late, because a lot of the Canucks' desperation just came at the very end. Their first and second periods were not good, and overall, you know, it was a game that I felt they should have lost, but the fact that they were so close to not having just lost in regulation, it kind of does sting. But I will give props where I do believe props are due. I do think that Hutton and Pouliot especially had good games. Pouliot's movements, I thought his decision-making was really good in this game, and his movements were good. I really liked his play in this game. Gudbranson, solid hitter as always. Hutton, I felt like he was better in this game than he has been in the previous games. Forwards, though, I do kind of have an issue. I didn't like Sutter. Didn't like Burmistrov. Didn't like that line. That was not a good line. I didn't really agree with a lot of the decisions made in the line changes near the end of the game, nor did I really agree with a lot of the line changes made in the middle of the game, but, you know, Travis Green is going to run his team how he wants. But, you know, it still stings. This game, it stung, especially because the Canucks were so close to having gone to overtime. But that's only one of the Canucks stories today. The other Canucks story is Kole Lind, because I already talked about Kole Lind, but today was Team WHL competing against Team Russia in the CIBC Canada-Russia series. So basically a whole bunch of CHL teams. There's a WHL team, there's a Q team, there's an OHL team. They play against Russian prospects, and it's prospects versus prospects. You know, the North American guys, the Russian guys. Kole Lind. Kole Lind had 2 goals and an assist in this WHL 7-0 win over Russia. And Kole Lind, you know, this is the guy that the Canucks were able to take in the second round. This is the why isn't anyone taking Kole Lind, Kole Lind that we're talking about here. His first goal of the game was a really good snipe. Kole Lind's shot, it's really good when it needs to be. And it's just so pleasuring seeing the Canucks and seeing the Canucks not doing well in their own games as a Canuck team and seeing the prospects doing very well on the outside. But, you know, Kole Lind, he's a story. He's going to be a story here in Vancouver, and if we keep him, he will be a good player on this team. Nobody's over here saying that he's going to be a first-line elite player because, oh, he has more points than Cody Glass. Nah, it's not really like that, but it's kind of a guarantee, you know, for a player who's kind of going to make an impact here at the NHL level. Whether that be a really strong impact or just a small impact, he's probably going to make the NHL. Let's be honest here. Kole Lind has had such a good career so far ever since being drafted by the Canucks, and it's just such a fun thing to watch right now. All these Canucks prospects building themselves up outside the NHL and improving, and that's what Kole Lind is doing here. So on this night where the Vancouver Canucks, well, they lose 3-2, and Kole Lind has a monster of a night for Team WHL. I'm LegoRockSlide9 Gaming, hope you guys enjoyed this video. True or plus, which is down with your trolls like and that's LegoRockSlide9 Gaming. Comment down below what you guys think of the game, Kole Lind, all that stuff, and bye.